fracking is a form of natural gas drilling, an alternative to oil, cause the oil kept spilling, bringing jobs to small towns, so everybody's willing. People turn on the lights and the drillers make a killing.
Water goes into the pipe into the ground, the pressure cranes fishes 7,000 feet down. The cracks release the gas that powers your town. That will frack, yet totally frack.
But there's more in the water than just H2O. Toxic chemicals help to make the fluid flow, with names like benzene and formaldehyde. You better keep it far away from the water supply.
The drillers say the fishes are a mile below the groundwater pumped into American homes, but don't tell it to the residents of Subway-O. That water's frack. We're talking benzene.
What the frack is going on with all this fracking going on? I think we need some facts to come to light. I know we want our energy, but nothing ever comes for free. I think my water's on fire tonight.
Bonjour, aujourd'hui en Roumanie, il y a plusieurs communautés, plusieurs villes qui s'unissent et qui organisent une journée anti-lutte chevron. Solidarité.
With the EPA out, it was over the stakes, but they didn't have the money to investigate. Sick people couldn't prove fracking was to blame. All the while, while...
Cuando pasó esto con el agua que habían empezado con el fracking es un asesinato del agua potable. Están destruyéndolo todo. Se juntaron, se juntó la gente no mapuche y la gente mapuche haciendo manifestaciones y protestando.
What the fuck is going on with all this fracking going on? I think we need some facts to go.
Au nom du comité belge de solidarité avec l'Équateur face à Chevron Texaco, on tient à vous remercier pour votre présence et pour votre soutien. Comme vous le savez peut-être déjà, cette action répond à l'appel des victimes de Chevron dans 5 pays différents. Les États-Unis, la communauté de Richmond, l'Équateur, l'Amazonie équatorienne, pardon, l'Argentine, la communauté de Neuquén, le Nigeria et la Roumanie. Aujourd'hui, dans plus de 20 pays, auront lieu de petites actions toute la journée pour cette première journée internationale anti-Chevron. Pour rappel, en Équateur, Chevron a opéré pendant plus de 25 ans, entre 1964 et 1992, et à son départ en 92, elle y a laissé plus de 450 000 hectares contaminés. Elle y a déversé des eaux toxiques, elle a laissé s'écouler du pétrole brut, elle a obligé des peuples locaux à se déplacer et elle a causé l'extermination de deux peuples indigènes locaux.
Water goes into the pipe into the ground. The pressure cranes fishes 7,000 feet down. The cracks release the gas that powers your town.
Chevron currently trying to do in Romania is to take over the whole state. They have like 4 perimeters which represent up to 10% of the Romanian surface. But we have information that they are actually behind other concessions throughout Romania, and they are really pushing to start a fracking against a very strong public opposition. And beyond that, we have a community, a fight that has turned quite famous around Europe and around the world. It's the village of Bunjești, a formerly laid back, unknown place in northeastern Romania, which has been invaded by Chevron and the riot police. And now we have a military state there. The people are not free to move around. The riot police is defending the compound, the surface where Chevron has illegally gotten the ground, and people were protesting for 6 months now, and despite that, despite the international outcry, they are now drilling and soon they will be fracking, and the people in the community are just frightened about what's gonna come, because they know what Chevron has done in Ecuador, in Nigeria, in California, in the States, in Angola and elsewhere. And we as Romanians are opposed to this politics of the USA, who is trying to take over Eastern Europe, which is now transforming more and more into what South America used to be in the 90s. It's now their heaven. And today we have Joe Biden, the Vice President of the United States, visiting Romania and trying to push even more for the aggressive start of fracking in Romania and also in other countries in Eastern Europe, on the background of the conflict with Ukraine, which is of course for them a good argument, energy independence and all this, but I can assure you that Romania is actually producing more energy than it's consuming. So for us, this argument has no value. It's just bullshit. Thank you. Chevron, go home! Go home! Chevron, 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 go home!
It was in the States, but they didn't have the money to investigate. Said people couldn't believe fracking was to blame. All the while, water was growing up in flame. Cause it's hard to contain all the methane release. If you get into the air, it can get into the streams. It's
esas técnicas que están prohibidas en otros lugares del mundo las utilizan sin problemas en América Latina para abaratar costos. Chevron Texaco, y Texaco en particular, también British Petroleum, en muchos conflictos utiliza también el dinero para crear milicias privadas, como en el caso de Colombia, que atentan contra los sindicalistas, con los pueblos indígenas para robarle las tierras. Hoy en día estamos frente a un proceso difícil, porque Texaco ya perdió en Ecuador, pero no contento con eso, intenta ganar en Estados Unidos y en otras partes para culpar a las propias víctimas, a los pueblos indígenas, a los campesinos y al Estado ecuatoriano, culparlos y hacerlos condenar. Texaco debe pagar y nosotros desde América, desde el corazón de Europa, llamamos a la solidaridad. Este es un combate que comienza y esperamos que todos juntos sigamos trabajando unidos. El comité que funciona acá en Bruselas está abierto a todas las asociaciones que quieran participar en el combate común contra esta multinacional y para que se haga justicia.